Hey fans of high quality entertainment, I thought I would do a reaction to this video I came across called How to Send an Email. So this is from 30 years ago. No, 40 years ago. 84, 94, 04, 40 years ago. Oh, I'm old. Yeah, so 1984. So let's get started here, and hopefully I can do a little funny quip or two during this. And I've just seen the beginning of it, and I thought it would make for a high-quality video for you to watch. Here we go.
With the assistance of the outside broadcast unit, we will be linking from the database studio to their home. Pat Green and Julian, welcome to Database.
Hello, Jane.
Hello, Jane.
Now, Julian, I see you have your computer linked to the telephone line. Can you tell us how you did that?
Yes, well, it's very simple, really. The telephone is connected to the telephone network with a British Telecom plug, and I simply remove the telephone jack from the telecom socket and plug it into this box here, the modem. I then take another wire from the modem and plug it in where the telephone was.
Yeah, that certainly brings back memories, you know, when I'm sure for a lot of us, you know, around my age, I'm 66, that I think we got our first personal computer about 1987, 1988. And, you know, you had to use your phone line. So you could either, if you wanted to use the phone, you couldn't be on the internet. I remember my sons, when we'd come home from shopping or whatever, I'm going on the computer, you know, or I'm using the phone. So, you know, you couldn't go on the internet. And of course, you know, going onto the internet, there was that really loud, annoying sound that would last like for eternity, it would seem. Here we go.
I can then switch on the modem and we're ready to go.
And I think the first one was like a 33.6 kilobytes, and then we upgraded to 56K.
The computer's asking me if I want to log on, and it's now telling me to phone up the main Presell computer, which I will now do.
It's a very simple connection to make.
Extremely simple. And I can actually leave the modem plugged in once it's done that.
And the old dial phone. I still remember my family phone number from back in the 60s. 392-8861. Don't call that now because you won't be talking to me.
Without affecting the telephone. I'm now waiting for the computer to answer me.
Yeah, good luck with that, especially early on. Sometimes it wouldn't connect. It would be just so annoying.
It asks with a tone, and then I just flick a switch on the modem and replace the receiver. And
things are starting to happen.
Things are starting to happen. The Presell computer is now asking me to enter my own personal password.
The password for today is password, or 1234.
Which I've now done. And it comes up with an opening screen.
Now, Julian, can you tell me, what is Micronet?
Well, Micronet basically is an area of Presell that's specially designed for microcomputer users. It has a lot of facilities. It has a magazine-type page of what's new today.
And I also remember when we first had the internet, you know, with the pretty slow connection, and there would be these websites, even like a, you know, not a fancy website, just a plain website, and it would take like a minute for the whole page to load.
The daily news, reviews of the current software that's available, there's a letters page that people can write in. There are programs available on Micronet that you can load directly down the phone line. Some of them are free, some of them you do have to pay for.
Now, Pat, whose computer is it?
Well, it's a cooperative, really. We all have a part share, but Julian and I mainly use it.
And why did you buy a computer?
Well, I was very interested in the new technology.
To watch Canadian Stud Muffin videos on YouTube, that would be my answer.
And didn't want to be left behind. I don't think it's only for the youngsters at school now. I think us older ones will have to learn a lot about it.
And what do you use the computer for?
Well, for keeping...
That's kind of a personal question. You might not want to know the answer.
Household records, such as what I have in the freezer and people's telephone numbers and addresses, I use it as a...
I actually have a list on my computer of what's in my fridge and freezer, too. It's crazy.
Word processor for my letters, which always come out perfect now. And the most exciting thing I find is the mailbox where I write to other people on the Prestel system.
And who have you written to recently? You got any examples?
Yes, I sent a message to my doctor asking for a repeat prescription, and he's left the prescription for me in the chemist.
Wow, that's impressive. I can't do that today. I can't even phone my doctor.
Right. Well, thank you very much, Pat and Julian. We'll be seeing you later in the program.
Bye, Jane.
If you have anything you want to say to us here on Database, and you're connected to the Prestel service, you can use the Database mailbox. Pat Green is still with us in North London, and she's going to demonstrate this facility by sending us a message.
Ooh, this is going to be pretty exciting.
Hello, Pat.
Hello, Jane.
Can you find page 7776, please? And now would you like to send us a message?
Yes, I will.
Electronically yours.
And I should be able to get the same message now.
Yeah, in about 5 minutes.
On my screen.
That's right.
Here it comes.
Thank you very much for your good wishes, Pat and Julian.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
And she just sent her a virus. She's not aware of that yet, though.
If I want to get that message printed out, I can do that as well, just by hitting this button.
Yeah, and then those old printers that were so loud and so slow. Memories.
And there it is. And by the way, we've heard some rumours that Commodore are planning to launch their own rival to Micronet, which will come complete with a modem. Now, as we get some...
Best of luck with that.
More news about CompuNet, we'll let you have it. In the meantime, if you want more information about Prestel or Micronet, then why not have a look at the Database newsletter, which you can find on Oracle, page 182. That's page 182.
Just a second, let me write that down. 182. Got it.
Now, if you own a BBC Micro, stand by for the software transmission. You can record the data directly from the audio track of your video cassette recording of Database. Alternatively, if your television has an audio jack or an ear socket, you can take the data directly from that. The least successful method is to just place a microphone in front of the television set. Now, if you haven't got a BBC Micro, don't worry, because during the series we'll be transmitting data for the ZX81, the Spectrum, the Commodore 64, the VIC-20 and the Dragon. Now remember, these software transmissions are experimental, but if they're successful and you like them, then they may well become a regular feature of Database later on in the year. Stand by for the software transmission. You better start your recorders now. Goodbye, and see you next week from...
Start the tape. I love how when there's a command, right, on that computer or right there, it needs to flash. Otherwise, you might not, you know, read it.
It's caught.
Start the tape. Stop the tape. Yeah, that is the noise, for those of you that don't know, of when you would have to connect to a phone line to get on the internet. And it would be really loud. like you couldn't turn down the volume or anything. I once threw my phone against the wall. I was so mad with that noise. It was so annoying. It should connect any minute. So I think that's it. Yeah. So no idea if anybody else is interested in this, but if you enjoyed this video, this reaction, please leave a comment below and a like, and let me know about your memories of, you know, some of you are young enough that you grew up with the internet, you know, and computers, but people, you know, my age in 50s and 60s, you know, it was kind of gradual the way everything was, you know, for the internet and everything. So thank you for watching and have a wonderful day. Not a great day.